Hello you, I'm Wally, and I'm going to have a whack at Ace Academy. It's a new game on Steam, well newish, it was released last month. Some cheeky visual novel action. Let's get straight into it. Welcome to Ace Academy. Let's get a few things set up. Ah, oh, that's a nice game, thank you. Oh, we get to name our character. Well, of course, it's Wally. Oh, our last name as well. Yes, Wally Wallington. Proceed as Wally Wallington. Hell yes. Yes, I will. Oh, I get... Oh, what? Ooh. Okay, what do I want to be then? I could be athletic, intelligent, or intuitive. Speed and endurance come naturally to me. I'm always looking for new ways to improve my strengths. I can hold my own in a fight and react quickly in tough situations. Ooh, so I could be a badass. Or I could be intelligent. Knowledge is power! I excel in academic studies and can pick up new things quickly. Exams are a breeze even with the little to no studying. Exams are a breeze with even little to no studying.
What a dickhead.
Intuitive. Do they look stressed? What's their body language like? What are they really trying to say? I've always had a knack for reading people and their emotions. I feel like intuitive would be good for a visual novel. Because then I can get all of the waifus. That's it. Good luck at Ace Academy. Thank you, game. Let's go.
Attention passengers.
Oh, it's speaking to me.
We will be arriving at our destination shortly.
I'm on a train then. Where's our destination then?
Please ensure you have all your belongings prior to exiting.
Okay, thank you. Dot dot dot. Dot 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 dot. Dot 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 dot. Hatsia! Something strikes my cheek. Oh, what is it? I turn away from the window and see a small hand beside me. Oh, okay. This is high tech. Oh, hello. Nikki. I glance at her sleeping form. She was always a bit of a restless sleeper. I move her hand back to her side. Not as gently as I could have done it. We're almost there. She may as well wake up. She stirs and stretches wide. Okay, she stirs and stretches with a wide yawn, hitting me in the face again. Ah! That one she must have done on purpose.
What a bitch.
Oh, hey bro. Huh? Looks like I dozed off there.
No
Did
shit.
You sleep well?
Ooh. Revenge. What is this sleep you speak of? Grumble, grumble. Okay. This seems like the most boring option, so that's straight out. What does that even mean? I'm very tempted. It'd be quite a brotherly thing to get revenge immediately. But this option is just the most entertaining. I couldn't sleep. What? No.
Why not?
I'm pretty sure there was a bear sleeping near me. At least, that's what it sounded like. Oh, get wrecked! Her eyes grow wide. I can see that.
Are you trying to say I snore?
Yes. Honestly, I'm surprised it didn't wake you.
You're joking, right? Do I really snore?
How can such a small person make such a loud noise? Oh, this is siblings right here.
I can never show my face in public again.
What?
Long rides are going to feel even longer if I can't nap. And what about sleepovers? Can I even get a boyfriend?
It's just snoring, woman. Jeez. I can't keep a straight face any longer. I burst out laughing. Nah, you're fine, sis. It was the guy behind us. She hits me in the arm again. I should have got revenge.
That is not funny.
Yes. But I can see the smile threatening to escape her lips. See? She understands. The sun shines in my eyes, catching my attention. Ah! It burns! The light, it burns! The sky is ablaze with deep reds and orange. As the sun creeps forward, its reflection... Wait, what? The sky is ablaze with deep reds and orange as the sun creeps towards its reflection on the glittering ocean. Oh, wait, where's the ocean? Is that it? Oh, okay. A soft breeze ripples the trees beyond the coast. The leaves seem to wave goodbye to us. Ah, that's so cute!
Doesn't it look like something out of a fairy tale?
It does. Just waiting for Natsu to just jump in and burn everything to the ground. She does kind of look like Lucy. There's a smile on her lips, but her warm eyes search my own. After a moment, she looks down and slinks back into her chair.
You know, you didn't have to come too. You were already in your first year at CINY, and, well...
Sam.
You didn't have to come too.
But you wanted me to, didn't you? Uh-huh. Okay, great back I go then. That is the kind of humour that this character of mine, that Wally P. Wallington, seems to have. Or I could be nice this time. Or I could just be a condescending bastard. No, this. That's a relief. I'll just wait for the train to turn around then, and I'll take the first flight back to the States. Oh, you knew your big brother, don't you? Her eyes grow wide and she bites her lip. Oh my. Trying to keep the worry out of her face. Wait, she seriously believed me after the whole snoring incident? I can't help but laugh. Ha ha ha! We're starting over here. A new life. There's no way I'd let you do that alone. Ah. Oh. Relief floods her face and she smiles. What a smile. But more importantly, I heard Japanese college girls are turtle babes. Yeah, man, up top. Ooh-hoo. Nikki's smile stays, but she rolls her eyes.
You're ridiculous.
Yes.
We have arrived at Izokaze Station. Please stand clear of the doors.
I can't see that door. The door that's like 50 meters away. Okay, I've got that job done.
Oh, that's our stop. Come on.
As we exit the train, I'm bombarded with a cacophony of noise. That's what train stations sound like. A businessman walks briskly past, talking sternly on his phone, while a nearby mother tries in vain to soothe her screaming child. A group of older women sneak quick glances at us and whisper amongst themselves. Every so often, they burst into laughter. What? Why? Why are you laughing at us? Is it because we're foreigners? Racist old women. Nikki eagerly steps off the train and breathes in the cool air.
That's more like it.
What was that? She glances back at me and puts her hands on her hips.
Hurry up, slowpoke!
Okay. Struggling with the weight of both... Oh, really? Struggling with the weight of both our luggage, I stumble off the train. The suitcases fall and gracefully beside me onto the platform. It's a good thing there's nothing fragile in here. Offering to carry both of our bags no longer seems like such a good idea. Why did you offer? You stupid man. Great. Fantastic. Wonderful. I take a moment to stretch my burning limbs. You've only stepped off the train. It's been like, I don't know, you might have been carrying them for 30 seconds. I should have picked athletics, shouldn't I? You see Uncle Kaito?
Not yet. When were we supposed to meet him?
6:30-ish. Looks like he's running a bit late. Oh, the old stew. Maybe he was murdered. Probably traffic. Or murder. After a few minutes of scanning, a familiar face appears out of the crowd. Oh, is it going to be our old... Oh!
Uncle Kaito!
Kaito. Let's get that in edit.
Welcome to Japan!
The English! Why is it in a different font? Nikki giggles at Kaito's English.
Hello, my name is Nikki.
Oh, the humor is real. Hey. Oh! Yes, Hero. Why, Hero Dairy! Oh my god. They both stare at me. They should. That was cringe. What?
You can't say that. That's offensive.
And you weren't being offensive. You two would just do the same thing. Yeah, what the hell?
You have quite a bit to learn, kiddo.
So this Japanese uncle of ours has an American accent. I suppose that could happen. Nikki crosses her arms and nods in agreement. Yeah, I can see that coming. See that happening. What did I do wrong? You don't know? Oh, come on. Ah! A loud grumble interrupts us. Are you hungry?
Sorry.
Don't apologize. Oh, wait. Oh, that's the best name ever. My last name affects everybody else's names. Uncle Kaito roars with laughter.
Let's get some food in you.
Where's the roaring laughter, mate? Shall I do it for you? Oh, okay, enough of that. Let's go. Okay. Run away. ... Is this going to be a recurring theme, do you think?
Welcome home.
Ooh. So we're staying with Uncle Kaito. This is swanky. This place is the opposite of the cozy yet cramped apartment I expected. Instead, I feel like I've just walked into the cover of a home decor magazine. Oh, I like this music. The accordion is real. Enough of that.
You guys hungry? Dinner should be here soon.
We are hungry. Did you not hear her stomach rumbling, Mr. Uncle Man?
Sweet. What are we having?
Well, I figured it'd be good to expose you to some true Japanese Ooh. Cuisine.
Is it gonna be jelly donuts? Witches.
Sushi, of course. 100% bona fide nigirizushi tomaki sushi.
Sushi! Sounds good. Damn it! I hate raw fish. But you know what I do love? Jelly donuts. Sushi! Great, I love sushi. Kaito grins. Look at that, that's great.
Your American sushi can't even begin to compare to the authentic
stuff. Ooh, shots fired. Just like America does all the time.
By the way, your things came in a few days ago. I put them in your rooms. Why don't you two go upstairs and start unpacking while I get dinner ready?
Okie doke, Kaito. Sounds good. Nikki nods and we head upstairs together. Why don't you just cut them out and go straight to it? The hallway upstairs is narrower than the one back home, but Kyoto's house is not small. Nikki heads into the first room on the right. My room is right beside hers and Kyoto's is further down the hall. Even with all of the boxes lying around, I'm surprised by how spacious my room is. It might even be larger than my dorm room at Sine. I head over to the wall and sit on the edge of my bed. Thank goodness Kaito had the beds made before we arrived. I don't even remember which box holds my linens. Maybe it's this one? Wait, it's been like 2 days maybe. Tops. And you can't remember what box has your clothes in. I pull the nearest box towards me and rip open the top. Just clothes in here. May as well start putting some of this away though. I've just emptied the box when Kyoto's voice echoes from downstairs.
Hey guys, fruit's here!
Alright guys, I didn't really plan this video ahead very well and it ended up being really long. So I'm going to split it in half, but there'll be a part 2 soon. Oh, grubs up!